I think the first presentation, what Lokesh started with first antipsychotics, and what Rashmin entity, I think what is maybe confused, what happened here? What are you talking about? We started with first antipsychotics causing TD, and the second study says, okay, fine, everything is equal. Second generation, first generation, everything is equal. And I know while publishing this data in this journal and all other journals, we refused by most of journals. They say, boss, what are you talking about here? Because you are talking about that, you are saying that second generations, they talk, we know literature. I am going to come to literature also, one by one, how, what literature says. But to courage to publish this, no journal has courage to publish. They say, boss, what are you talking about? You all are sponsored by all pharma companies. And you say the second generation caused TD and is as much caught in life first generation, what are you talking about? And what the viewers comment is something like, huge list of viewers comments. And even if we reply viewers comment, they don't publish. So finally, Asian Journal, Keshwan, somehow they published the Asian Journal study. And this is something, but this is the one study, but what to say? So we know about a lot of things about TD till now, that this is involuntary, non-ending, repetitive purposeless, hypothalamic movements, and all sort of buccal mastic tip syndrome we all know from our, I think, MBDs, this is the syndrome we're talking about, and all sort of definitions of those things. But as sir pointed out, whether we really see TD, sir, we really see TD. The OPD, we have 800 old patients used to per day in Ibhas OPD. You often say, every 10 patients of TD. So TD is not vanishing. It's not gone. Though the second generation come up, the last one decade, we saw a lot of change to second generation antipsychotics. So things, TD, the person of TD, we said, what to answer him? What is he want to say? He is TD. Dr. Sahib, what will happen to me? Will it be okay or not? And at times we have no answers. We know what the limitation management we have on TD. Because this is something more disfiguring, something more disabling, and what a poor quality of life the person used to suppose survive. Already suffered from schizophrenia. We have given more this disorder, TD. And this schizophrenia and TD, both things go side by side and lives become more health. So this is something the person more prone to, more sort of all the side effects, and the very important part, second symptoms, remissions. Then more relapses are there. The person who had TD, they have more relapses of psychosis. That's the worst part, because again, we have limitation of medications. If you stop one drug, then definitely more psychotic relapses. A lot of studies speak about that, something about worsening of psychotic symptoms because of TD only. 8.8% of this worsening something, comparing this 5.2 versus 2.7% of without TD patients have. So more worsening patients with TD. So this is very disabling for the patients. This very interesting thing, from who at all this study make out, this is, with TD also leads to more cognitive symptoms. Patient have more cognitive symptoms, the person have TD, if you treat the persons, they have more cognitive symptoms. And they again worsen time by time. So this is something new appeared last year, this study. So again the question, first generation versus second generation. What my colleague started with that, he said first generation, this, he said okay, this is something equal. But what I tried to dig out, what literature we have till now, because first, let's start with numbers. He started with the one prevalence talking about HGA is equal to FGA. In numbers, this is something, first generation, this meta-analysis say about all sort of, the last meta-analysis about TD in FGA and FGA. This FGA say 5.5 versus SGA 4.0. If you see the percentage, right, this is in that way, the FGA not bad as we used to presume, what this meta-analysis says. And the last very important thing is, this
this target with adult, this something with all mixed populations. When it's zoomed to the only schizophrenia adult populations, difference is there. 3 versus 10.7. He speaks about CATI study, and this see this table I just see, right from olanzapine, quetiapine, risperidone, perphenazine, prednisone. You see the numbers. No difference at all. What CATI studies, no difference at all. So, though we all the time say that SGA is very good for all other EPS and all the TD symptoms, but this is CATI study says, sorry, no difference at all. All patients may develop TD. Though other studies about first of all schizophrenia, though patients who develop schizophrenia first time and when they start antipsychotics, this something difference is there. This study definitely say that okay, start the second generation, start the first generation. When we speak about chronic TD patients, those who are chronic TD patients, now definitely this is one study from published in AJP. This is the African descent patients, and they have followed this cohort of get antipsychotic for 18 years. They say TD chances 10.2%. So again, this is more first generation antipsychotics, but this is more important that patient may develop TD even after stopping treatment up several years. So not we stop medicines, so no TD happen, but TD may occur after stopping medicines also. This is very cause of concern because as you started with spontaneous dyskinesia with associated with the schizophrenia, same possible the person has exposure to antipsychotics. When this study speak about children, targeting children population, and you see this data, there is close incidence rate. SGA 0.3.8 and SGA 0.42%. So close. When other populations say about bipolar, again 2.64, SGA 2.18. Very close number they are. Elderly population, this because what Rashmi pointed out that age is the very advancing factor, very important for development of TD. And this first study, this something by Dinda Jeste et al. And colleagues, did this something about 5.2 versus 5.2? There's no significance, there's no difference at all between FGA and SGA when used antipsychotics elderly. I find very interesting this why I did this data. And the last slide, but something same group, I think just in 2000 they had something say while they're reporting SGA 2.6%, basically they're talking about when the patient exposed to the SGA, adult patients having psychosis. This is last meta-analysis that I when I dig out, but again This is again talking about mixed populations. So again number varies there. This is the number game, so I am not expert in Dr. E. Mohandas used to say that okay, this number. So we don't know what number means. This is something 30.4 for SGAs, 30.1 for SGAs. The patients not taking any drugs, they have more spontaneous dyskinesia. So what means this meta-analysis? When I dig out what happened in the course of TD, what happened in the course when both these FG and SGA compared? There are a lot of studies happen in era of FGs. And most of the studies, some studies say improved TD over a period of time, some say steady, and some say worsening of symptoms as the time passes. When we speak about as second generations, then they say that okay, boss, this is something six up to 6 months they are less likely chances. If person has got change from say getting SGA, they have less chances of getting say TD. This is something 43.6 SGA, 60.8 FGA. Whether this TD remains persistent, then again question asked. This is something this is again studies and
they speak about 5 to 15 years. There's something with, let's start with FGA. They say after 5 years, 32% chances, 57, 68, depending on years they predict this day. And when they say SGAs, again, prediction is something like that they have low propensity of SGA towards to as time passes or they persist, really persist. So, just to, when Lokesh presented at that time, we are not agreeing that FGA caused a lot of worsening. Worsmin say that FGA is almost equivalent to FGAs. Somewhere, FGAs are upper hand, we all know. But FGAs, that they're not caused TD, there's no, not now, we are not, I think now, another literature is there, we say that FGA also caused TD. Still, a lot of studies need to be done, long-term studies, prospectus needed, with give the definite answers that which is more prefer or which. And this is a very interesting area because this is something we used to object assign. So the psychiatrists or researchers, at least as a part of the psychiatry work on this particular this phenomena. And thank you, my colleagues. Thank you, Pearsons.